Judge puzzled. Damning text message made 6 weeks before Lizard's murder. All of that coming up in this video. Stay tuned. So I'm going to be reading from Jamaica Gleaner. I'm going to be leaving the reading down below in the description so you can read for yourself and get a better understanding. What I'm going to do, I'm going to read it in my own way and thing. Hope you understand. The metadata for one of the damning text messages which prosecutor used to convict top entertainers Vybz Kartel, Shawn Storm of murder was created 6 weeks before the victim's death, one attorney has told the appeal court. Bianca Samuels, one of the attorney for Shawn Storm, was referring to the text messages reportedly found one of the mobile phone taken from Kartel, in which it was said that Clive Lizard Williams chop up fine. Samuel was making her submission in the appeal filed by the two entertainers against their conviction and prison sentence. She said the evidence presented during the 17 weeks murder trial that ended in April 2014 shows that the metadata was created on July 6, 2011, 6 weeks before the prosecutor claimed Williams was killed. Samuels noted too that there was evidence that the mobile phones taken from Kartel were used while the instrument were in the custody of the police. This one has left me puzzled, said Samuels, who along with Hizat Buchanan and Dania Allen present Shawn Storm. The panel of three judges hearing the appeal appeared surprised by the assertion. Our silence was sharing your puzzlement, said President of the Court of Justice Appeal, Dennis Morrison, who along with Justice Patrick Brooks, Frank Williams are hearing the case. Samuel said the raise more than reasonable doubt about the integrity of the evidence, which should not have been put to the jury. Vybz Kartel declared his innocence. My hands are clean of Clive Williams' blood. That was the declarance of dancehall entertainer Vybz Kartel in his unsworn statement at his murder trial in 2014. Kartel, whose real name is Adija Palmer, said, my lord, my hands are clean of Clive Williams' blood. If indeed Clive Williams is deceased, he said, there was a group of persons conspiring against him and his friends. He referred to then National Security Minister Peter Bunting, who said took his music and image to the United States, claiming that Vybz Kartel lyrics, my lord, is glorifying in scamming. So them chat Vybz Kartel for music, it seems. Anyways, let's continue. The dancehall artist had said that Bunting said that there were four essential elements mashing up Jamaica, and I was one of them. Kartel said the statement was prejudicial to his case. He said he was heavily tattooed and he bleached his skin, but that was merely super official because that was part of the persona of Vybz Kartel, not Adija Palmer. The Crown had led evidence at the murder trial that Williams was beaten to death at Kartel House at 7 Swallowfield Avenue in Avondale, St. Andrew, on August 16, 2011. It is alleged that Williams was beaten over two missing guns. The body has not been found. So there you have it, people. The text message made 1.5 months before Lizard's murder, and higher authority go to the US board and say, yo, Vybz Kartel music, I promote scamming. You remember one time Vybz Kartel is sing the song name Big Up Every Scammer, we make US dollar? Them did ban that song there, you see me? And from then, them just say, yo, them want Vybz Kartel, you see, him a mash up Jamaica, you see me? A member say, no, he's a big top ranking police, he say, Vybz Kartel responds to over 100 murder, I think, you know, you see me? Correct me if I'm wrong, but me a try to show you, say, yo, them a deal with Vybz Kartel based off of him name. Them not deal with him based off of him birth name, you know. After the Vybz Kartel brand, so them a treat him. Treat him gunman music, them, him hardcore dancer song, them and them thing there. Them never did try Adija Palmer. Them try Vybz Kartel in the court. You understand me, I say? So that basically go on, people. So viewers and subscribers, only think about that. If we see, say the text message made 6 weeks before Lizard's murder, and then everybody say, yo, Jano Star Vybz Kartel is this big criminal. Let me tell you this, you can't fight the system. There's nothing you can do. You have to just sit down and just watch the system do it work. You see me? Vybz Kartel could never do nothing. You see me? Anything when him say or do, I go use pan him in the court of law. So Vybz Kartel do the right thing, calm down himself and just say, yo, Your Honor, my hands are clean. I did not do anything. But them no want to hear what him have to say. So they're going to say, alright, if you say that and we see say your hands clean, we are going to put some dirt by your hand. Because you're going like say you never do nothing. Alright, cool. Even if we know say you do nothing, we still are going to make you do something. So you're going to do some time for you, you see me? You're going to do with you, you're going to run some time. You see? We not happy, but me not like you. You understand, people? Me not say that them basically do, but that me think them do. Is in other people, I think so. Also, you understand.
First of all, explain for us the procedural differences between a trial case and an appeal case.
Right. So let me start by saying and making clear that I'm not on the Vybz Kartel team, legal team.
And we know.
It's important to say that because the courts in our country are very careful, and the code of conduct for lawyers. When a case is before a court, they want lawyers to be very careful about how much of the actual substance they discuss in the media.
Oh,
okay, so as an officer of the court, I have to respect that, but I can certainly help you in understanding your questions.
Okay, so explain that question for us. The differences between, procedurally, between a trial and an appeal.
Okay. So, in a trial, you are charged with various offenses. In this case, the person would have been charged with murder, conspiracy to commit the murder. What then happens is that a jury is empaneled. So you actually have two judges in a trial. You have the judge of fact, which is a jury. And then you have the judge regarding the law, which is a trial judge.
Okay.
And so the role of the trial judge in a trial of that nature is to manage the case, to ensure that the rules of evidence are correctly applied, and to ensure that the jury gets proper direction as to considering the facts that are put before it.
And the appeal
The
judge?
Appeal now is a panel of three judges. And so at the appellate court, what the court is most concerned about are questions of law. Have questions of law been properly applied to the trial process?
Okay.
Okay, so the appeal court doesn't normally hear evidence, and that is perhaps what has made the team upbeat. Because it is rare that an appeal court will allow fresh evidence to be adduced. The formal term is to adduce fresh evidence. And you have to go through certain steps. So you have to show first why that evidence was not available during the trial, and you then have to show why you say it is relevant to the consideration of the appeal.
So the appeal is a review.
Okay, so let's look carefully now at the question of the appeal.
Yes.
The appeal is a review as to the grounds of appeal you put forward.
Okay.
Okay? In this particular case, which is a criminal appeal, this is what the court is to do. The court, on any such appeal, and I'm reading from the relevant act that governs this process. So the court, on any such appeal against conviction, shall allow the appeal if they think that the verdict of the jury should be set aside on the ground that it is unreasonable or cannot be supporting having regard to the evidence, or that the judgment of the court before which the appellant was convicted should be set aside on the ground of a wrong decision on any question of law, or that on any ground there was a miscarriage of justice. So let's back up and look at the two things. Obviously, a question, a ground on a question of law is going to look at the relevant laws that apply to the issues in the trial. An example, let's take the adducing of electronic evidence. So in this case, we had evidence of voice notes. We had GPS evidence that was put forward to show where certain things occurred, where calls were terminated, etc. Okay? You have to follow certain rules to put that evidence in.